Attitude, The Remarkable Power of Optimism, by Nido Qubein. Read by Patrick Lawlor. Introduction. If you want to reach for success in every area of your life, the most important asset you can have is a faithfully optimistic, winning attitude. Literature and history are full of people who suffered from severe handicaps, often had talents that were inferior to those around them, sometimes lived in the worst of circumstances, usually faced many defeats. Yet many of those people are listed among the winners in life's Hall of Fame. Why? What made them achieve when others around them failed? When others had greater talents? When others had greater opportunities? When others often had far greater resources? The secret is this: they had optimism and developed a winner's attitude. Whether you reach success or failure in life has little to do with your circumstances. It has much more to do with your attitude, with your faithful courage, with your choices. You see, non-achievers blame their circumstances. Winners rise above their circumstances. Some concentrate on the blank wall that boxes them in. Winners always look for a way to get under it, over it, around it, or through it. At High Point University, we create an environment that encourages our students to adopt a winning attitude, to be extraordinary. Our goal is to weave students into our HPU family rather than to weed students out of the system. Over many years of consulting with business organizations and associations with individuals of all ages and at all levels of accomplishments, I have been fortunate to accumulate a treasure trove of wisdom about developing an optimistic winner's attitude. Much of it has found its way into books I have written or into videotapes or audio tapes I have made, as well as through speeches, seminars, and newsletters. In this book, I've tried to refine this accumulated wisdom into short entries that can be listened to quickly, absorbed easily, and applied successfully. It is content that I share in courses I lead for freshmen and for seniors at High Point University, and now I'm happy to share it with you. Whether you are a student in college or an executive of a major organization, I hope you will find this book a pleasant source of inspiration and advice. Nido Qubein. Pessimism leads to weakness, optimism to power. William James. How do you get out of bed? There are two kinds of people in the world, positive people and negative people. Optimistic, positive people spring out of bed in the morning and say, "Good morning, Lord." Pessimistic, negative people pull the covers over their heads and moan, "Good Lord, it's morning again." Which kind of person are you? I can't change the direction of the wind, but I can adjust my sails to always reach my destination. Jimmy Dean. Optimist or pessimist, it's your choice. Whether you are an optimist or a pessimist, the choice as to how you will be in the future is yours and yours alone. If you are like the people who aren't happy unless they are miserable, you can stay that way. If you want to be joyful, enthusiastic, and excited about life, you can be, regardless of your circumstances. You were born to win, but to be a winner, you must plan to win, prepare to win, and expect to win. Zig Ziglar. Develop a winner's attitude. Success is mainly a question of attitude. If you go into an undertaking expecting to succeed, the odds are great that you'll succeed. If you go in fearful of losing, you're more likely to lose. If two evenly matched football teams clash on the field, which is likely to win? In all likelihood, the school with a winning tradition. That's because its players expect victory. If a team has a losing tradition, its players are often surprised by victory, which is why they have mediocre seasons even when they're loaded with talent. It's been said that the late Bear Bryant, legendary football coach at the University of Alabama, went into each game with a winning attitude that was worth at least one touchdown for the Crimson Tide. Cultivate a winning attitude. It will sustain you even when the odds seem stacked against you. You were born to win, but to be a winner, you must plan to win, prepare to win, and expect to win. Zig Ziglar. Develop a winner's attitude. Success is mainly a question of attitude. If you go into an undertaking expecting to succeed...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.